guys, Marina here from Yes to Tech. Welcome to Tech Tuesday, where we remove the tech stress that comes along with running a successful online business. Today we're going to talk about how to edit videos on iMovie. This is the perfect solution for those of you who are creating YouTube videos, online course presentations, and evergreen webinars, and wish to take the unedited footage of whatever it is that you're recording and transform that into a cohesive video by removing the excess and adding all of the necessary bells and whistles. The best part is that we'll do this in a way that's fast and easy, even if you've never used iMovie before. Stay tuned until the end of this video to learn how to edit videos on iMovie and to get my webinar sales funnel template that'll help you boost your webinar signup rate, increase the number of people who show up live, and skyrocket your sales. Also, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every Tuesday when I post a new video. All right, so let's get right into how to edit videos on iMovie. To open iMovie, you can either go to Finder, Applications, and then select iMovie, or use the search tool in the menu up top to open the Spotlight search. Start typing in iMovie and click on the app to open it up. In iMovie, click on Create New, then on Movie, and on Import Media to import your video clips, and then on Import All. Drag and drop the movie clips onto the working area in the chronological order that they'll appear in the video. The first thing we'll do is remove any excess footage. For instance, if you record your video in short snippets, like I do, the beginning and end of each clip, when you've just pressed record, or are searching for the stop button to end the recording, will be excess. So let's go ahead and delete those. You'll know they are excess by the lack of voice bars. As you can see, there is this time frame at the beginning and end of each clip without these voice peaks, which means that you're not talking at these moments. To cut part of a clip out, select the clip that you wish to edit, place your cursor where you want to trim the excess, right-click, and select Split Clip. Or just press Command B. To delete the excess, just select the excess clip and press Delete on your keyboard. The same exact process can be applied if you wish to delete a section in the middle of a clip. Select the clip that you wish to edit, place your cursor at the start of the section which you wish to trim the excess of, right-click, and select Split Clip, or just press Command B. Now, place your cursor at the end of the section which you wish to trim the excess of, right-click, and select Split Clip, or just press Command B, and press Delete on your keyboard to delete the excess out of the clip. Now that the video doesn't have any excess footage, it's time to add the bells and whistles. The first thing we'll add is our social handle to the top left of the screen with a bell sound to the introduction of our video. For me, the easiest way to create this is with a Canva graphic. If you don't have a Canva account yet, just click the link in the description box below to create one for free. Once you've logged into your Canva account, click on the blue Create a Design button on the top left, and then on Custom Dimensions. The size of a YouTube video is 1920 pixels by 1080 pixels, so choose that as your dimensions and then click on Create Design. Now click on Text from the left-hand side menu, add a heading, and write at your social handle. In my case, Yes to Tech. You can customize this text to look the way you wish by editing its font, size, color, and appearance. If you want to add your own font to Canva, as you can see I've done over here, make sure to watch my video on how to upload your own font to Canva. The link to it is in the description box below. Let's place this in the top left corner. After you've edited your text to look the way you want and wish to save it to your computer, click on the downward pointing arrow on the top right and make sure that the file type is PNG. Since we want this white background to actually be transparent so that this text overlays whatever it is you're showing in your video, you need to click on this transparent background checkbox before downloading. Transparent backgrounds in Canva are a Canva Pro feature, which you can try out for free for 30 days by clicking on the link in the description box below. Now, back in iMovie, click on the downward pointing arrow up top, locate the Canva design you just created, and then click on Import Selected. Drag and drop it to the working area to the location of your choosing. With that Canva clip selected, click on the Crop tool from the menu up top and switch from Ken Burns to Fit. This will ensure that your social handle is fixed to the screen. You can reposition its clip so that it starts and ends exactly when you wish. And you can increase or decrease the length of its clip by dragging either side of the clip. To add the bell sound, click on Audio from the menu up top, search for bell, and drag and drop it onto the working area so that it starts at the same time as your social handle appears on the screen. To ensure that the bell sound doesn't overpower your voice, play around with its volume slider so that it's exactly as you wish. Now let's create graphics to overlay part of our video. You can either have a piece of graphic that covers the video entirely and serves as B-roll with your voice still coming through, or you can have a translucent graphic that allows your video to still be slightly visible. Let me show you how to do both in Canva. Again, we'll be creating a custom design that's 1920 pixels by 1080 pixels. To create a graphic that serves as B-roll, you can add whatever element you wish to this design, including background, text, images, and icons. Just to show you an example of what this B-roll will look like in iMovie, I'll use one of Canva's pre-made templates. Click on the downward pointing arrow up top and download it to my computer. To create a translucent graphic that'll allow your video to be slightly visible underneath, create the design that you wish in Canva, and then decrease its transparency. Click on the downward pointing arrow on the top right, make sure that the file type is PNG, and click on this transparent background checkbox before downloading. Again, transparent backgrounds in Canva are a Canva Pro feature, which you can try out for free for 30 days by clicking on the link in the description box below. Back in iMovie, click on the downward pointing arrow up top, locate the Canva designs you just created, and then click on Import Selected. Drag and drop it to the working area to the location of your choosing. Just like we did before, with that clip selected, click on the Crop tool from the menu up top and switch from Ken Burns to Fit. Again, you can reposition its clip so that it starts and ends exactly when you wish, and you can increase or decrease the length of its clip by dragging either side of the clip. You'll notice that the design you created in Canva that has an opaque background will cover the entire video, and replace the video with your design, whereas the one with a slightly transparent background will just serve as an overlay. Say that instead of a graphic, you want to insert a screen recording to this video, for instance, where your audience can go to download a free guide. You can do so with QuickTime. To open up QuickTime, you can either go to Finder, Applications, and then select QuickTime, or use the search tool in the menu up top to open the Spotlight search. Start typing in QuickTime and click on the app to open it up. When you open QuickTime, click on File from the menu up top and then on New Screen Recording. Record whatever it is that you wish and then save the clip to your computer. In iMovie, import the screen recording clip you just did and drag and drop it to the working area to the location of your choosing. Just like with our Canva design with an opaque background, you'll notice that this screen recording will cover up and replace the video underneath it. Another thing we can do in iMovie is zoom into a particular section of a clip to emphasize a point. We'll do this in two ways. One to bring the focus to the speaker, and another to bring the focus onto a button. To bring the focus onto the speaker, make sure that the clip you want to zoom into is its own clip. In other words, you've already separated it from the clips that go before and after it. Now select that clip, and from the menu up top, click on Crop, and then on Crop to Fill. Bring in the corners, and reposition the focus area so that the visible screen is tightened. This will give that zoom effect that you're looking for. To bring the focus onto a button, such as a subscribe button, click on the same crop menu up top, but this time select Ken Burns. You'll notice that there's a start and end sections. You can leave the start section as is, but reposition the end one so that it focuses in on your button. You'll notice that as this clip plays, it'll zoom in and bring the focus to the button you selected. The final thing we'll do is add music to our video. To do so, go to YouTube, click on your icon in the top right, and go to the YouTube Studio. From the menu on the left, click on Audio Library. This is where you can download royalty-free music and sound effects to add to your video. Click on the downward pointing arrow on the right to download any of them to your computer. And then import it to your video in iMovie. Drag and drop the music file to the working area and bring down the volume slider so that the music isn't too loud. You can have this song playing throughout the video or just at specific parts. For instance, say that I want to play it just during this video intro. So I'll go ahead and cut it right where the introduction ends. So that the song doesn't end abruptly, we can fade it out by grabbing this little circle on the side and dragging it towards the middle. Now you know how to edit videos on iMovie. If you plan on using this edited video for your webinar and wish to take your webinar efforts to the next level to boost your webinar signup rate, increase the number of people who show up live, and skyrocket your sales, make sure to get my webinar sales funnel template by clicking on the link in the description box below. So, what do you plan on using this edited video for? Leave your answer in the comment section below and make sure to click on the link in the description box below to get the webinar sales funnel template and to get a free 30-day trial of Canva Pro. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.